The home of the president, Washington, D.C. The American flag is a symbol of our nation, the United States of America. A symbol is a picture or object that represents a word or idea. A nation is a country. You can see that the flag is red, white, and blue. You can see that it has red and white stripes. It also has 50 white stars, and each star is a symbol for one of the states in the United States of America. There is one very important city in the United States that is not in any of the 50 states. In fact, it is the nation's capital. It's the city where most of the decisions that affect the country are made and where the government is located. Our nation's capital city is where the President of the United States lives, Washington, D.C. The president is the elected leader of our country. This means that the president was chosen by the people of our nation. Men from each of the original colonies helped write the Constitution, a plan for how the new country should be run. We call these men the Founding Fathers. The Founding Fathers decided they wanted the country to be run by a president instead of a king. Once a person is king or queen, they remain in that position for the rest of their life. They are not elected by the people and might not represent the interests of the people. The Founding Fathers didn't want one person to tell everyone what to do as a king does. Instead, they wanted a leader who would listen to what the people wanted and work hard to get them what they needed. To make sure the president didn't become like a king, they decided to write the Constitution, a set of rules for the president to follow. They also decided that the president would have to be elected by the people. The president would not be born into the position like a king is, and he could only be a president for 4 years before the people would vote for president again. When the Founding Fathers started to think about where the president would live, they started to worry. If the president lived in the state he was from, it would make that state feel more important than all the others. The Founding Fathers were afraid that one of the states would try to take over and be in charge of the others. They decided to write into the Constitution that a special city should be built, no bigger than 10 miles wide, which would serve as the nation's capital. The capital city would not be in any state, so no one state could say that it was in charge of the territory. This city was to be called Washington, in honor of George Washington, our first president. Eventually, Washington grew into the area we now call the District of Columbia, or Washington, D.C. If you visited Washington, D.C. today, you would be able to see the White House, the house where the president lives. The president moves into this house when they become president, and then moves out when the next president is elected. But not just presidents live there. Their families, and even their pets, come with them to live in the White House. Have you ever seen pictures of these dogs? Their names are Champ and Major, and they live with President-elect Joe Biden and his wife Jill. On January 20th, 2021, Champ and Major, along with Joe and Jill Biden, will move into the White House when Joe Biden becomes the 46th president of the United States. The president doesn't just live in the White House. They work there, too. The part of the White House where the president works is called the West Wing. The president's office has a special name, too, the Oval Office. Sometimes the president signs laws or gives speeches from the Oval Office. One of the president's most important jobs is to enforce the rules of the Constitution. To enforce the rules means to make sure the rules are followed. The president doesn't run the government alone as a king would. The government is made up of a team of three groups: the president, Congress, and the Supreme Court. The founding fathers made sure that all three, the president, the Congress, and the Supreme Court, had equally important jobs so that the president didn't hold all the power like a king, and so that people's liberties would be protected. Because so many of our past presidents have lived in Washington, D.C., it is also a place where people often build statues and other buildings to honor them. These statues and other buildings are called monuments. If you visited Washington, D.C., you would find many monuments to past presidents. One famous monument is called the Lincoln Memorial. Another famous monument is the Jefferson Memorial. These monuments are symbols to remind us how important past presidents were in our nation's history. The Washington Monument is one of many people's favorite monuments to visit in Washington, D.C. It is the world's tallest stone building. When you go to the top of the tower, you can see all of Washington, D.C. But you don't have to go to Washington, D.C. to appreciate our country and its leaders. If you want to show that you are proud of your country, you can say the Pledge of Allegiance or sing the national anthem. Here is the text for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.